thing here. Is that really what I look like? Jesus Christ. Wait, sorry. My speech is on my phone. I got it in my pocket. First of all, thank you all for being here, really. My dad, I have a lot of respect and love for my dad. And so before I begin, he always asked me to do this anyway. He wants me to say thank you to the Almighty because it is his will that allows us to be here. And one of my favorite phrases is mashallah. So, you know. I'd like to begin by quoting Shakespeare. There is a tide in the affairs of men, which taken at the flood leads us on to fortune. Omitted, all the voyage of their life is bound in shallows and in miseries. On such a full sea are we now afloat, and we must take the current when it serves or lose our ventures. Now, I made one almost fatal mistake when I confronted AOC. And that was that I said, unless you choose to stand against nuclear war. And the reason I believe this was a mistake is because nobody has the privilege to choose anymore. That is a luxury that we lost a long time ago. You have to act. It is no longer the choice between action or inaction, but action or non-existence. Now, what do I mean when I say action? I mean we act in the name of love for mankind. And that love dictates how we act. But love isn't easy. Because it requires a certain strength to find within yourself. Because when you talk of loving humanity, that means you have to include people like AOC and Bowman, the squad, even President Biden, Putin, everybody. See, these people, especially the squad, were like you once. They were in your shoes. They believed in the best of government. They believed in the best of people. They thought themselves to be the change they wanted to see. They really did believe that. And maybe some of them still do. But when they see you and me now, and when they see somebody confronting them, they don't see you. They see the ghost of their former selves. The person in them, in the back of their mind, who they tried to kill off. They see themselves at a point when they also were angry and they believed in making people uncomfortable, just like all of you do now. And that's what scares them. Because your voice and their ghost is louder than all the PR people who talk to them, all the Vogue covers they're on, all the press they get. Nothing will ever suppress the voice in the back of their head that knows they're doing something wrong. They have found themselves lost in a dark wood, and sadly, their guide was not a Virgil, but Satan himself. But we have the privilege to be guided by the work this organization has done for the last 50-some-odd years. And we can pull out the squad and other people who've been misguided and show them that there is a way forward. And in the tradition of Dante, it is only right that we take upon the mantle to trek through the many layers of hell that we find ourselves in today. And with reason as our guide and love, excuse me, and with reason as our weapon and love as our guide, we can trek through the deepest layers of hell as Dante did and come out the other side in a world full of optimism and hope for all. A world when everyone can be allowed to develop their minds to contribute great discoveries. And my friends, I am proud to say today that although we may find ourselves in a dark wood, we are not alone. The love that moves the sun and all its stars is the same love that will move us to act for the sake of our posterity. And to whoever is listening to this conference long after every one of us is gone, I hope the love that has resonated today has reverberated and may reach you wherever you may be. Because this conference was always for you. It's not for us, but it's for those who come after us. And that is in the name, and it is for those people who will be born long after you're dead that we act for and that we do this for. It's not for us, but for them. Thank you.
Congresswoman, none of this matters unless there's a nuclear war, which you voted to send arms and weapons to Ukraine. Tulsi Gabbard, she's left the Democratic Party because there are a bunch of war hawks, okay? You originally voted, you ran as an outsider, yet you've been voting to start this war in Ukraine. You're voting to start a thermonuclear war with Russia and China. Why are you playing with the lives of American citizens? You're playing with our lives.
There will be no neighbors if there's a nuclear bomb. You voted to mobilize and send money to Ukrainian Nazis. You're a coward. You're a progressive socialist. Where are you against the war mobilization? He's telling the right truth. You have done nothing. Tulsi Gabbard has shown guts where you've shown cowardice. I believed in you, and you became the very thing you sought to fight against. That's what you've become. You are the establishment, and you are the reason why everybody will end up in a nuclear war unless you choose to stand up right now and denounce the Democratic Party. Will you do that? Yes or no? Okay, simple. Are you going to stop nuclear war? Yes or no? There is no line, because this is bullshit. None of this matters if we're all dead. None of it. You know that. Then let's take it up right now, because this is the only thing that matters. This is the only thing that matters right now. We could be in a nuclear war at any minute, and you continue to fund it. That's what's going on. Why not right now? You're the liar here. Nobody has held you accountable. That's what's happening. And it is time for you to stand up and realize that what you've been saying has been lies. Let your conscience come through for once.
In a moment.